When I was little, yeah, my mother got her hair fixed down here, and she'd give me 50 cents, and I'd go to the bakery and get a brownie, and then walk over to the hardware store and get her seeds that she wanted for the garden. And every single store was open. That was when I was little. And then the mall opened. That started killing downtown.
Trent and Stephen like to refer to the building before they got their hands on it as like the ugly duckling in downtown Kinston. There wasn't one window in this whole place.
When we started the brewery, we both kind of had fond memories of what Kinston used to look like when it was the Magic Mile. I mean, I used to come down here and go shopping with my mom when I was little, and we kind of wanted that down-home feel. We never really planned what was going to happen in the tap room or what has happened to Kinston. It's crazy. When we started, it was the chef and the former was over there. We were here. We were kind of the anchor on this corner. They were kind of the anchor on that. And it's just been crazy to see all the development and all the tourism and all the other new businesses open because there's so much going on downtown.
Our quality starts with using the correct grain and the correct yeast that is true to that style. So our German beers, the grain comes from Germany. Our Belgian beers, the grain comes from Belgium. Our IPA, sure, the grain comes from America. We don't use one yeast strain. We use the correct yeast for every single beer.
I've always been under the belief as a brewer about being traditional about beer styles that are out there. We have these traditional styles, and I try not to skew from them. Now we've got the third best Kolsch in the world up against where it started from.
So quality and the use of the correct ingredients is really important to us. We really are craft brewers.
There is a lot of effort that goes into getting 12 ounces of beer in a bottle. You know, from the moment it's being, the grain's being ground up until it gets fermented and then gets transferred, gets carbonated, and then transferred into bottles. When we started working with Atlantic, they've been very communicative, and we've had a great relationship. It's just a lot less of a stress situation when you know the materials you're going to use to represent your product on the shelf is made by a company that it cares about what your product's going to look like in the end.
We want to make a great product. We want to continue to grow the brewery, but we never, ever, ever want to lose the character that is the basis of our brand.
The great thing about Kinston is it's like I look at it like art. It's an empty slate because you've got all these empty buildings. So you can recreate it however you want. We'll never be the Magic Mile again. Not for cars, clothing, and all that. But we could be the Magic Mile for entertainment. I think that's what we'll be known for in the next 20 years.